Hey everyone, so we're back in beautiful Kelowna with our next highlight holes video featuring the Okanagan Golf Club Quail Course. So at the Okanagan, you've got two courses, the Bear and the Quail, both very enjoyable, similar look and feel. The Quail was actually the original course and is often referred to as the more difficult of the two, which I would agree with. Has a great layout with lots of variety throughout the course. Majority of the Quail has tight tree-lined fairways, but from holes 14 to 16, it does open up to a little bit more of a links-style course with water and fescue to contend with. The greens here often have ridges that can lead to some challenging but fair putts throughout your round, and I definitely encourage playing safe golf on this course. You'll see why as we jump into the drone flyovers. So we're gonna kick it off with hole 6. It's an S-shaped mid-length par 5 ranging from 420 to 520 yards. You've got elevated tees down to a split fairway, which makes for a forgiving tee shot. You just got to pick which fairway you want to aim for. If you want to try and cut the corner, go for the lower one. Play the course safe with a three-shot hole. Then you can go for the upper one. Given the shape of the hole, you essentially need to cut the corner perfectly if you want to give yourself a chance at getting on the green in two. With that being said, if you play three safe shots, there's not a lot of trouble you can get into, and you know, stay out of the sand, stay out of the trees. There's no reason why you can't walk away with a par or a birdie if you play it strategically like that. And up next, we got hole 9. So it's the 3 cap on the course with distances ranging from 290 up to 440 yards. Definitely one of the more challenging holes here at the Quail. You've got a tee shot through a chute of trees with a narrow angled fairway, which means you don't have a lot of green space to work with vertically. If you go a little bit long or hit a draw, you're probably gonna have a terrible lie up on the left-hand slope there if you're not in the trees. And if you go too right, then you gotta hope for a good kick down into the fairway. Going short off the tee could leave you with a 280 plus yard approach shot, which is not ideal for this long par 4. It's also a smaller green, sloped from back to front, with a significant ridge in the middle. So when you're on the green, don't expect an easy two putt on this 9th hole. You walk away with a par or a bogey and plan for a strong start to the back 9. Hole 12, so it's a 520 yard par 5 down the hill. Plays fairly short because of the slopes that you have to work with. Definitely reachable in two with a good tee shot. And it's a tight fairway that slopes left to right. If you do roll off the fairway down to the right, you can still end up with a fairly good lie most of the time. It's not super thick rough. You'll find your ball and it's pretty flat as well. So not a huge issue as long as you stay out of that fairway bunker on the right there. Lots of bunkers throughout this hole to watch out for down towards the green as well, and they're all well placed, very easy to find. And the center of the green is depressed, with the front and back portions a little bit elevated. So if you have a mid pin, that's great because a lot of your approach shots are gonna funnel down into that. If you're on one of the upper tiers, it plays a little bit more challenging. We're gonna skip over to hole 15. So it's a long par 3, 230 yards from the tips, much more open when compared with the other holes we've already discussed. Other than the bunkers, really not a lot to worry about on this hole. It's a nice big green as well. It is very undulating, so I just want to avoid the dreaded three putt on this one. And finally, gonna wrap up with the hole that closes the round, number 18. It's just an awesome finishing hole. Very tough par 4. It's the 2 cap on the course for good reason. Ranges from 230 up to 408 yards. It's a sharp dog leg left and requires a very well-placed tee shot. You want to make sure you get past the trees, but you don't want to go too long, because if you go too long and you're through the fairway, you're probably going to have a sloped lie, which given the green and the pond that you have to shoot over is going to make for a very difficult second shot. And then you've got a narrow elevated two-tiered green. So if you're on the green and reg on this 18th hole, be sure to give yourself a pat on the back from me because you've earned it. As always, please hit the logo to subscribe, and remember, you better be keeping the ball straight. Thanks for watching.